Thank you for joining us today. We've gotten a lot of interest for our Supply Chain Analytics Professional Certificate Program, and we've asked our professional education instructor, Darrell Kent, to join us today to give us some more insight into the program. Darrell, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
So give us a quick overview of the certificate program and, you know, so that people can understand it.
Sure. The Supply Chain Analytics Professional Certificate Program is a four-course program designed to help individuals and organizations optimize their supply chain operations using data-driven insights. The course covers a range of topics from data collection and cleansing to advanced analytics techniques such as predictive modeling and optimization.
That's great. Who's the course designed for?
Well, the course is designed really for anyone who's interested in understanding and leveraging their data to improve supply chain performance. This includes professionals in supply chain management, logistics, procurement, and operations, as well as students and researchers in related fields.
What do you consider some of the key learning takeaways that students will find when they complete the program?
Right. Well, by the end of the program, students will have gained a deep understanding of the role of data and analytics in supply chain management. They will be able to collect and clean data from various sources, apply statistical and machine learning techniques to extract insights, and then use these insights to make data-driven decisions that improve supply chain efficiency, reduce costs, and enhance customer satisfaction.
Wow. What are other strategies and skills they'll gain from participating in the program?
Well, one of the things we cover in the course at great length is a scheme that talks about strategic decisions, tactical decisions, and operational decisions. So in the supply chain world, some of the decisions you make last a long time. I might make some decisions today around what my warehouse network is going to look like nationwide. And that's a decision I'll have to live with for a certain period of time. So that calls for a certain set of approaches. A second set of decisions are tactical decisions. In other words, decisions I make today that I'm going to have to live with for a few weeks or months, that requires its own set of approaches. And then finally, there's operational decisions, decisions I need to make today, but I can revisit tomorrow. We call those operational decisions, and they again require their own special set of approaches. And we cover decisions in all three areas in the course in some detail.
So supply chain analytics, and analytics has a lot of definitions and interpretations. So what are the different types of analytics that specifically apply to this program?
Well, students will gain insights into really four kinds of analytics that are commonly used in supply chain applications. The first is descriptive analytics. So analytics that really will provide insight into what happened. What happened, and am I happy with it or am I not happy with it? So that's one area. A second kind of analytic is what we call diagnostic analytics, which is, why did this happen? And if I have some insights into why it happened, maybe I could do things I wouldn't do otherwise. A third kind of analytics is predictive analytics. So can I predict what's going to happen? And if I'm reasonably comfortable with my prediction, will that allow me to take actions I might not otherwise take that will improve performance? And then the last area is prescriptive analytics. So in other words, analytics that suggests things that I ought to do. Again, that might be different than things I might otherwise do. So prescriptive analytics is really providing insights into actions I ought to take.
So to earn the certificate, students have to complete four courses in the program. Can you go over those four courses and kind of give us a little bit of an insight into what the students will be learning and just kind of some key takeaways?
I can, for sure. So course number one is transforming supply chain management with data. And some of the key topics there are using analytics to transform supply chain management. We're going to look in a fair bit of detail at exploratory data analysis. Lots of times you're going to get supply chain data from lots of different places. And there's really a craft is what people in the field have discovered in terms of how to understand what you have and improve it so that it can be useful for decision-making purposes. We'll look at performance analysis and visualization of supply chain data with the advent of Power BI and other visualization technologies. Lots has been done to visualize the performance of supply chain. So we'll look at that in some detail. And then finally, we'll cap the first course by looking at how to use descriptive analytics in a comprehensive way in supply chain management. So that's course one. Course number two is creating business value with statistical analysis. Things like asking the right business questions from a statistical point of view. We're going to be looking at a number of different kinds of statistics for supply chain data. We'll be looking in this course at models for inventory management, which are really statistically driven in many cases. And then finally, we'll finish off with time series models, which are a statistical method that's used in many cases for forecasting purposes. So that's course number two. Course number three is machine learning applications for supply chain management. And in that course, we'll provide a solid grounding on what is machine learning exactly. And then building on course number two, we'll look at a time series application of machine learning. We'll spend some time looking at machine learning for classification and clustering, which are two key application areas. We'll spend some time looking at how do you evaluate a machine learning model and what's a good model perhaps versus not a good model. And then in day four, we'll look at a concrete example looking at predictive maintenance, which is how do I use data to make predictions around when maintenance might be needed. So that's course number three. And then course number four is supply chain optimization and prescriptive analytics. And in that course, we'll provide a grounding in what is optimization exactly. And then we'll look at applications in production planning, in routing and network design. And then we'll complete that course with some nuts and bolts tactics on how to tackle prescriptive analytics projects. So there are the four courses. So just to summarize again, transforming supply chain management with data, creating business value with statistical analysis, machine learning applications for supply chain planning, and finally, supply chain optimization and prescriptive analytics.
Wow, thanks. That's great. You know, Georgia Tech's all about real-world application, hands-on experience. So what are some of the examples that concrete problems that students will learn about that actually have been applied, and we'll show them how they can apply this to the program and to their own industry and careers?
Well, one of the examples we look at is an example from the fiberboard industry where companies are making the material that would go into boxes and other similar materials. They use a very large piece of machinery called a Fourdrinier machine, which maybe would be the size of a big room. And this machine essentially takes pulp and other raw materials in one end, and out the other end produces fiberboard, which is an intermediate product, again, that would go into boxes and so on. One of the decisions, you know, if you're a manager of this operation, is what should my maintenance policy be? These machines are expensive to begin with, so you don't want to have them down more than needed. And also, if they break down on an unscheduled basis, that can be very costly. So the question is, you know, what might a good approach be in terms of when you would do maintenance? And the key thing we look at is building a model that will predict breakdowns. So if I can predict with some certainty we're here, for example, maybe it's the 1st of May. If I can predict with some certainty it's going to break down on the 24th, I can make decisions around maintenance that I might not otherwise do. And then the big surprise, I think, for students is really how valuable that change of decisions might be. We spend some time in that example looking at, you know, not only the change, but what was the value of the change from the point of view of the company that owned the Fourdrinier machine.
Very valuable. You have other examples that you can share?
Well, throughout the course, we look at a constructed case featuring a company we call the cardboard company. And the cardboard company operates at two stages in the fiberboard industry. They make raw material fiberboard, and they also make boxes. So we're going to be looking at that company in a fair bit of detail and really looking at all stages of supply chain management, all the way from things like network design. What should the network look like? How should they approach production planning and inventory management? And we also do a little bit of routing with that company as well. So looking at when products are being delivered to final customers, and you've got for example, a warehouse that with a fleet full of trucks that's making deliveries, how do I plan that work for optimal productivity?
Perfect. So all of our students are working professionals, So I know they're interested in, you know, how are the courses delivered and what they can expect and so forth. So as an instructor, can you kind of share that information with us on like how the courses are set up and kind of what they need to expect?
For sure. So the course is delivered as a live virtual class. It includes lectures and hands-on exercises that allow participants to apply and practice the concept that they've learned to real-world problems. Participants also have the opportunity to interact with instructors and fellow students in both our lectures and in our online forum.
So what is a typical course schedule look like for one of the courses?
So each of the courses is 4 half days. And generally, we're running those courses Monday to Thursday, and the courses typically run in the afternoon. So we're generally going from 1 to 5. So it's each course is 4 half days, again, running from Monday till Thursday. And if you look at kind of the before, during, and after for each of those classes, before each class, there's generally a pre-course webinar where we're covering some of the assumed capabilities, particularly in the areas of Python and Power BI. We also have some one-on-one meetings just to understand what the student's trying to accomplish so we can make sure that the lectures are geared around their needs. So that's before. During, if I can talk about the experience during the course, we run the course through Zoom. We use a full-featured learning management system called Canvas that has lots of elements that facilitate the learning process. And then in terms of the tools, we're working with Python. We're using Power BI. We're using Miro, which is a wall boarding application. That's basically the tools we're using during the course. And then outside of the course, there's online discussions. We have options for makeup and review sessions and lots of offline help and support along the way.
That's great. Who are the instructors? Because there's 4 courses. So what can a student expect for the instructors?
I can speak to that. So the course instructors are 2 of us, myself and Matt Chamberlain. We're both professional educational instructors with Georgia Tech. Matt is an optimization engineer. He's worked with clients to scope, develop, and deploy prescriptive analytics applications in a wide range of contexts, ranging from network design and commercial design, all the way to operational production and inventory management. And in particular, he's got a lot of experience in the oil and gas industry and in the consumer products industry. So that's Matt. And then in terms of my background, I had more than 10 years of experience helping companies to deploy advanced analytics solutions, typically as part of wider digital transformation and supply chain efforts. I've had a lot of experience in the areas of pricing management, demand forecasting, and resource planning. As well, I've worked on numerous projects in the areas of network design, trucking-related predictive maintenance, and also looking at how reinforcement learning, which is a topic in machine learning that we're going to talk about the course, how that can be applied to supply chain applications. And then we typically have guest lecturers, often PhD students at Georgia Tech and or Georgia Tech faculty members. Yona Berger, a recent PhD student and now with Shopify, was a guest lecturer last year, as was Mathieu Don, a professor in the School of Industrial and Systems Engineering at Georgia Tech. And then for the next few lectures coming up, Benoit Montoy, who's also a very senior professor at Georgia Tech, and if I can also say as well, fellow Canadian, will be joining us for the next set of lectures.
Thank you. One of the questions we get repeatedly is, you know, are there prerequisites for a student to have before they enroll in this course?
Ideally, students would have some grounding in supply chain management, that they know something about what a supply chain is. They would have had some exposure to statistics. So there's going to be a lot of review of statistics in the program, but hopefully it won't be the first time they've seen it. It would be helpful if they had a little bit of exposure to coding in Python and also some experience or some exposure to a dashboarding tool like Power BI.
Awesome. So if someone wanted to learn more about the course, and you're the instructor, so if there's wanted to learn more about the course or how to register or get more information, what's the best way that they can get that info?
The easiest way to get more information on the program and upcoming class dates is to visit the website. So we'll flash the website on the just on the screen here, but that's probably the best way to get information on the course.
Right. Well, I appreciate you taking the time today to join us and give us more insight on the program. And I really appreciate your time. And thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Looking forward for sure to connecting with some of your viewers in our upcoming program.
Great. Thank you for joining us today on our podcast. You'll find all the links below, as well as additional information on how to contact us. We look forward to connecting with you soon. And again, thanks for joining us.